many athletes spend time trying to figure out Evan Bourne, and as much as you think you have him figured out, an athlete such as Evan Bourne can turn the tide of a match so quickly. That's what makes Evan Bourne so exciting.
Morrison again putting those shoulders down, and Evan Bourne, after the euphoric victory last night, is certainly back down to ground now.
Oh, absolutely. The euphoria comes and goes, the ebbs and flows of life here in the WWE. And it's something that Evan Bourne and every other superstar has to learn to adapt to if you want to reach the pinnacle, which is, of course, the top of the WWE.
This crowd getting behind Evan Bourne.
Watching Evan Bourne with Rey Mysterio, watching him shine, the question popped into my mind is that how Evan Bourne was going to fare in individual competition. Every superstar needs to be versatile. You need to be apt at tag team wrestling, singles wrestling, you know, extreme rules wrestling, anything. I mean, look, this Monday, CM Punk and Chris Jericho inside of a steel cage. How do you prepare for that?
You don't. I don't think anything could have prepared us for what we saw at Unforgiven. Truly one of the most remarkable nights we've had in the WWE in a long time. So unpredictable, so exciting. In fact, in our ECW Championship Scramble match, there were no less than 5 pinfalls in that 20 minutes.
God, a plethora of emotions. There were 3 championship scrambles, and 2 championships changed hands on that night.
John Morrison, who certainly still has his eyes on the ultimate prize, the ECW Championship, trying to impress Theodore Long with what he's doing to Evan Bourne here. And let us not forget, Evan Bourne has only been pinned 1 time here on ECW, that by The Miz, which qualified The Miz for that championship scramble.
Well, Todd, I encourage all of our fans to do their homework and validate that statement. I ran into Mike Knox earlier today, and he questioned some of the statements that you had to make about Evan Bourne only being pinned once, but that's neither here nor there. I'll let you deal with Mike Knox on your own, okay, buddy? Okay, pal? Look at you, your hair's so cute.
Evan Bourne trying to get this crowd behind him, get back to his vertical base.
There's interesting, trying to get a leg out from underneath of John Morrison, and John Morrison is again using that strength advantage.
Here's the cover, Tuna.
Todd, being a competitor, being in that ring, you mentioned that Evan Bourne is trying to get the crowd behind him. There are times where, as a superstar, you don't even realize that the crowd is there. You realize the competition. You realize your opponent in the ring. If the crowd comes along for the ride and they want to cheer you, well, that's all well and good. But Evan Bourne is a true competitor, and winning comes first. Although this crowd here in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, certainly getting behind Air Bourne.
Just when you thought things were going to turn around for Bourne, Morrison sends Bourne back to the mat with a crushing right hand.
You ready for this one? Will there be happy days here in Milwaukee? This will be a television show.
Morrison's ready for it. And John Morrison wasn't ready for that kick to the temple. Is this Bourne's opportunity to get the momentum in his favor?
Well, keep an eye on The Miz right there in the bottom corner of your screen.
Morrison now rattled. Oh, wow! A back kick by Evan Bourne! Shoulders down!
Evan should concentrate more on the injured John Morrison instead of, you know, being completely surprised. Watch here, this beautiful back elbow, and then watch here, the athleticism, jumping mule kick that sends John Morrison down. And again, keep in mind that a lot has been taken out of Evan Bourne here. Ooh. So it's a testament to him as an athlete, the ability that he has.
He's got those legs, this is it, Tuna. I was gonna say Evan Bourne's whole offensive game is based around his aerial moves, his strength in his legs, and the first thing to go when you're tired is your legs.
Absolutely right. Evan Bourne holding his lower back as well, and of course, if your lower back is hurt and you can't breathe and, you know, you're grounded, you can't fly, I'm pretty sure that Evan Bourne has a lot of other tactics involved. Look at this beautiful Frankensteiner, deep double leg hook, but not enough to keep down John Morrison. This is,
the standing moonsault does not land.
What do you say to that? Ow. Just look at it again and feel it at home if you...
In Milwaukee, we have a problem. The moonsault didn't land, but that knee by Morrison certainly did. And this could be it for the former ECW champion, a two count again.
I'm impressed with Evan Bourne. He's put up with a lot here in this contest. Take a look right here. Look at this beautiful knee strike. Right to the point of the chin. It's nobody home for Starship Pain. Can Evan Bourne capitalize? He's in the right position.
Miz looking around as if to get approval. And Bourne has found that approval. No, going after the Miz instead.
Wow, the kick turned him inside out.
And now
Evan Bourne is unconscious, Todd.
John Morrison dragging in the lifeless body of Evan Bourne, and that will do it.
Evan Bourne needs help.
Here is your winner, John Morrison.
I spoke earlier about Morrison and The Miz being on the same page, and right there, that momentary lapse of concentration as Bourne turns his attention to Miz was enough.
A little concern here for Evan Bourne.
Yeah, Bourne not moving right now.
Yeah, Bourne's hurt. Well, we thought he was going for Air Bourne, a move that we've come to know and love. The Miz providing a second's worth of distraction. And then, as you said, a momentary lapse of reason, so to speak. Look at that, his head even hit the ring apron. If it was not the kick, then it was the head bouncing off the apron. John Morrison, your victor.